Hi guys, it's Mike here, One Go Short Play.
My microphone is really quiet, let's sort that out. 1, 2, 3, here we go. Yeah, that's about right. Sorry, technical difficulties. Annoyingly, I've just played this game once through. Really enjoyed it. Columns 3? What happened to Columns 2? We just don't know. Annoyingly, I played it through. I really enjoyed it, actually, in some ways. And I've got to say all the same things about it again that I pretty much said before. I won't. I'm just going to play it and see what happens. It's got an intro sequence. Now, that sounds pretty annoying for a simple puzzle game, but this is where they've kind of advanced it a little bit. It's not very particularly pretty graphics-wise. It's all right. Basically, you go into a pyramid, and this is the cool bit. I'll skip. Go to normal. That was a really slow intro. Actually, I skipped it last time as well. I just saw that much of it to know there was an intro. This. Here I am. That's all that is, all he says. Last time I thought I'd skipped all the dialogue, but it turns out I hadn't. Turns out we're taking on enemies in that puzzle fighter kind of way. So, columns 3, I think that's pretty much all you've added. Nicer graphics. I mean, the more deliberate, the tidier. They are cleaner and a little bit more detailed, a little bit more panache to them. Just a little. That's going to wreck all the lines, isn't it? I was going to get blues now. And oh, screw it. Oh no, and that was for nothing as well, because I totally missed what I wanted to do. In fact, I would have missed what I wanted to do anyway. I don't know what I was trying to do there. I thought I had a colour I didn't have. And guess what? I didn't have it. I am doing rubbish here. Last time I played this, which was 5 minutes ago, I did pretty well. I'd say admirably, in fact. I was rather good. And this was the only problem I found with this game, and maybe it'll come through on this playthrough as well, was that it's too difficult from the word go. It's very unforgiving. I don't know what that spider's up to over there, because I am doing my thing over here. Get that one because it's higher up. I should go the other one because it's near the yellows and I had a better chance of getting yellows, but there's this one anyway. I'm just commentating on absolutely nothing there. That's a waste of time. What was I saying? It's really unforgiving. Now, if I can play a little bit better than I did before, because hey, I've already had a go, I might be able to beat him, but I do think on a game like this, where the levels are quite short, the difficulty are... Oh, he's done something to me there. I don't know what it is, but he's messed up me shiznit. Is that a swear word? I don't really like swearing on my channel. I like it to be accessible to everyone. I apologise if that is a swear word. I don't think it is. Anyway, he's a bit too difficult. That's my point. I'll go for... Oh, no, that, yeah, that's what I wanted. I'm not quite sure if that was the right thing to want, but we're going to find out. Oh, I needed that one, you little monkey. Oh, no. Oh, my yuck. So that's what my nieces call me when I annoy them, which is quite regularly. My yuck. tickles me. Oh, yeah, I'll get that. Now, that's cool. I think you just hammer it down when it comes down. And it actually... Oh, that was stupid. That was... Why my yuck? Why? Okay. I need to see what's coming. Hold on. I've just realised I can see what's coming in advance. You know what? Oh, you're an idiot. You're an absolute idiot. I mean, you really are. I'm making a mess now. It's all going wrong now. Yeah, that'll do. Okay, come on. Yeah, that's good. That's good. He's a bit too hard. I mean, I was playing a little bit better than I am now. I'm getting a bit of luck here, actually. But I was playing a little bit better than I am now. Just a little bit. I missed it. You are nasty, nasty little spider. And he still battered me. I mean, he absolutely battered me. And I felt it was a little unfair. I'm not saying I'm good at this game. I'm just saying I was better at this game than the game gave me credit for. I felt I was anyway. And I probably missed something there. And I don't know where all those noises are coming from. You know, you think you might have seen something that you could have used, and yeah. Spider! I'll put that there, because I can't. The problem is, I'm so busy concentrating on the gameplay that I can't see what's coming next, because I can't look up at it. Can't look in two places at once. That's a bit. I'm sure Tetris handled that better in terms of the screen estate. Oh, silly. Yeah, I did play definitely better than this before, but it still hammered me. And I think the levels are quite short and snappy, which is good, of course. But I do think that it would have been better if it gives you a chance on your very first go, or at least on the first level. On your first go, you want to kind of maybe have come close, at least to beating, yes, to beating the enemy. And, you know, then you're more inclined to give it another crack. I'm only giving it another crack now because... I don't know why I put that there. That's why. Because I've got to do the video again. It's just really annoying. Oh, we're... I thought there was blue coming there, but it's on the next one. There it is. Oh, and I did that on the other video as well. I think that's my Xbox pad, to be honest, not being a Mega Drive pad. Oh, that was so rubbish. I'm so dead. I'm so dead. I was also saying in the last video, in my job at Astroware, I was an artist there. We did a lot of games for, our demographic was middle-aged American women. Now, I'm not a middle-aged American woman, you might have noticed that. middle-aged, maybe, yeah, middle-aged, I'll give you that. But at the time I wasn't. I was in my 20s, late 20s, early 30s. So I'm drinking coffee, cold coffee now. And I wasn't into those types of games, but I tried to get into them, and got and a few that I really enjoyed. One of them was Puzzle Quest. I played that on the Xbox, and I played that on the, I think it was a Palm device. What was it? I can't remember what it was called now. It had like a stylus. Anyway, and I think I played it on a few devices, and some versions were really badly balanced. Some versions were really well balanced. Oh, a DS. I think that wasn't such a good version. I think the Xbox version was actually really good. It gave you a sense of immersion, it gave you a world with characters in it, and it's what I said about Chuck Rock. The characterization was good. Well, it wasn't great because the characters were a bit bland in Puzzle Quest, but the idea was good of being in a world. It felt a little bit Tetris meets World of Warcraft, if that makes sense. If you can ever make that crossover, if you can, Puzzle Quest managed it. A match 3 game, it's actually one of the better ones, I think. And yeah, we did a lot of them, so I had to get used to them. But yeah, this has a feeling of that well before that ever existed. So, you know, hats off to him for that. Columns 3, Sega Mega Drive. Pretty good game. Really hard, though. Too hard. Anyway, thanks for watching.